Hey there, here are 26 travel tips to help you pack your bag and get you through the airport to your final destination in the wintertime, around Christmas, in the summer, for travel to Europe. So let's pop into these 26 travel tips. The number one travel tip is to take the tube of icing out of the gingerbread house kit if you are traveling around Christmas time. My mom got stopped this last week because she did not take the tube out. It is less than 3.4 ounces, but it is considered a liquid. The number two travel tip is to unzip your boots about 2 inches if you are traveling in an airplane, because that will help with circulation flow and protect your veins. The number three travel tip is to turn your boots in the direction of the nearest stairwell when you are in a hotel room. If you wake up and there's a fire alarm going off and there's smoke in the hallway, you want your shoes to point in the direction of the nearest stairwell. The number four travel tip is to not pack a snow globe, even if the liquid in there is less than 3.4 ounces. It is kerosene, and my mother-in-law found this out in New York City when she tried to pack that in her suitcase. All liquids must be in a container that is 3.4 ounces or less. Even if you take a large shampoo bottle, but it only has 1 ounce of shampoo in there, they're going to confiscate it because the container has to be, or is supposed to be, 3.4 ounces or less. If it is in a carry-on bag going through that kind of security. The number five travel tip is to take booties. Like in the summer, in the fall, in the spring, booties take up less space in your suitcase. I have 3 different kinds that can be worn in the winter or in the spring or summer. They still give you a cute airport outfit look, but they take up less space. If you are gonna wear tall boots, wear them on the airplane and then pack your short booties in your suitcase because they take up less space. This pair is from Nordstrom, then I have Bear Traps, and then I also have some from Kohl's. Another reason I like booties is they are great for warmer climates and when you have to take them off in the airport or on the airplane. That's why I like short boots, because they don't get tangled up when you're back with your bags and stuff in the floor of the airplane. If that makes sense. The number six travel tip is, before you leave, to freeze a little cup of water in your freezer and leave it in there and put a quarter on top before you leave. And that way, if your power goes out, your freezer has not been open since you've been gone. And depending on how much water is in there or how little amount of ice is in there, you will know how long the power has been out and how safe your food is inside your refrigerator. The number seven travel tip is to store your liquids horizontally. Trust me, it works for saving space. And the number eight travel tip is to pack a cardigan or scarf that can work double duty. It can be a blanket or a warmer layer in the airplane, and it can also look cute, and you can mix and match with other pieces of clothing for your vacation. Another travel tip is to not wear white pants when you are in the airplane, because it's like when you tell your teen driver, it's not you that I'm nervous about, it's the other drivers on the road that I'm worried about. So in an airport, in an airplane, it is the other passengers that I'm worried about. They could spill coffee, leave greasy food marks or food stains on the airplane's airport seats when you're waiting to board your airplane, and save your gorgeous creamy white sweaters for your destination, not on the airplane, for the exact same reasons. The number 10 travel tip is to help you not have as much hassle and to stay cute in your airport outfit. Do not wear a big poncho or a shawl or something like that with big armholes or little armholes and lots of fabric down there. The fabric hanging down snags over the seats when you're walking down the aisle of the airplane sometimes, and it's just a lot less hassle, and it messes up your look if you put on a backpack or if you're trying to carry different bags. We found out in 2018 that distilled water is allowed in any amount through airport security. That's like you holding your gallon of distilled water for your CPAP machine. It is allowed through airport security. The 12th travel tip is to ask TSA a specific question about something you are thinking about bringing on the airplane through airport security or in your checked bags. Don't go to the TSA Facebook page. Go to Ask TSA Facebook page. It's a two-word place. They will get back with you with your personal question, answering you within 24 hours. I think their Facebook page response is faster than asking a question on their actual blog. Another travel tip for you is to pack a carabiner hook for your European travel, or if you're eating at a restaurant outside somewhere where pickpocketers could make a big scene and then steal your purse. Put your purse on the back of your chair and then hook with your carabiner hook. Go under that back strap and then hook your two straps together with the hook. It just will deter them and it won't let them pull it right off the back of your chair, if that makes sense. If you have a travel tip to share, please leave us a comment below. And while you're down there, introduce yourself and say, hey, I am a pilot wife in Houston, Texas, and I'm sharing these tips with you, and especially fashion tips for travel, on my Instagram page, Travel Tips by Laurie. So stop by and say hey. The 14th travel tip is to pack your belt in that outer pocket along with your jewelry in the outer pocket, or just stow your jewelry in the bag somewhere in your carry-on bag. And do not put either of them on until after you've gotten to airport security. I don't even put them on at home until I get through security. I go to the bench and that's when I pull out my belt and I put on my earrings. You'll get through security much faster and with a lot less hassle. The 15th travel tip is to pack loose change when you're going to a European vacation spot. A lot of restrooms with a man or a woman in the women's restroom will be there to clean your toilet before and after you go. And then also in Europe especially, they have these standalone self-cleaning toilets that look like a little elevator door. You go in and you use the restroom if you have paid to open the door, and then when you leave, it closes the door and then it goes and sprays down and disinfects the whole thing. But the main thing is that you are getting a clean restroom in a foreign city. The next travel tip is to use no vacuum cleaner compression bags by Ziploc. You just put your sweaters in or whatever clothes you have and zip it up 3/4 of the way. And when you start rolling, that actually activates the compression part. These work, help you save space in your suitcase. The number 17 travel tip is for Christmas and or Thanksgiving. My husband likes to put mashed potatoes and cranberry sauce on leftover turkey and have a sandwich. But if you are traveling, anything that can squish, mush, anything like that has to be stored in a 3.4 ounce container or less. And that liquid has to be inside a liquids bag, just so you know. And take it from me, do not wear those gorgeous slip-on boots that go up to your knees. It is so hard to keep your balance and it takes you a lot more time to take them off when you are going through airport security. The 19th travel tip is to store headphones or jewelry in your sunglasses case. And the 20th travel tip is my new favorite. A subscriber told me about this. If you need to hide cash in your suitcase, just put it in between the Kleenexes in your little Kleenex pouch. Isn't that so smart? And if you haven't already watched my travel or life hack video, you can also store cash in the padding of your sports bra and then pack that in your suitcase. The 21st travel tip is to not wrap your gifts before going through airport security. Save the wrapping paper for when you get to your destination. If a package looks suspicious, it will be unwrapped or investigated. And the next travel tip is to give fingernail polishes as gifts for your friends. Many of these fingernail polishes will fit in your liquids bag for travel, so you don't have to pay postage, and they are travel themed by the way they're named. Travel tip number 23 is to pack command strips. And when you get to your beach location with a large family or a family reunion trip, put those on the wall of your resort and then you can store wet bathing suits, wet towels, all that kind of stuff. Travel tip number 24 is for flying to a warmer climate from a cold climate or vice versa. Wear layers or pack layers. And I also recommend using the outer pocket of your suitcase and just stuffing your down jacket down in there and then just zipping it halfway to get it through the airport or to stow it in your overhead bin. And then if you want to change into flip-flops in the airport bathroom, then just put those in the inside little pocket or somewhere easy. They're flat and easy to pack. Utilizing your suitcase's outer flaps inside pocket is going to give you so much more space. Like you can pack 2 pairs of shoes in there, a hardback book. This is a very underutilized part of your suitcase that can store so much when you're packing. The last travel tip is to pack clothing that has cotton and polyester in them for less wrinkles or fewer wrinkles. This sweatshirt has 60% cotton and 40% polyester. It's very thin, so I can layer it as well. I have all these shirts. I have like 5 of them in all, and they do not wrinkle and they skim a woman's body while being flattering to her body type at the same time. Anyway, that is another travel tip. Thank you so much for visiting my Travel Tips by Laurie channel. If you have one, remember to leave a comment below, and thanks for visiting.